I've had a few people ask me what my imaging train looks like with my 8060ED and my field flattener. This is a field flattener and reducer combo, but from henceforth, I shall refer to this as just the flattener. And although I'll be talking about just my one specific refractor, the idea of the imaging train on how to attach your flattener should be the same for all refractors, for refractors that need it. So if you have a PET's file refractor or a quadruplet or a quintuplet or a sextuplet, six element glass refractor, they generally provide a flat field to begin with, so you don't need a flattener with those. And if you're using your telescope just for visual astronomy, then you don't need a flattener for that either, but you should watch this video anyway, because I may or may not reveal the secrets of the universe. And I'll show you how I connect my imaging train with both my DSLR and an AstroCam. And I'll briefly talk about backspacing as well as attaching a filter to the mix. My 8060 comes with a dedicated flattener. So what that means is that there are M54 threads on both the telescope side and on the flattener side that I can just screw this in. And on the other end, there are M48 threads that will connect your camera. It's generally more secure and it decreases the likelihood of any tilting of the imaging train. If you use a more general flattener, such as this Hotech 2-inch flattener, then one end will be a 2-inch nose piece that'll just go into the 2-inch visual back of your telescope. So in a minute, I'll mount my telescope and we'll start connecting everything so you see just exactly how my imaging train looks. But first, let's take a look at a two-dimensional view of what my imaging train looks like. Here's a quick look at the layout of the telescope, filter, and camera in the order that they'll connect. This is just a very basic look at the setup with just a telescope, flattener, and camera. Here's the basic setup with a DSLR instead, extremely similar. Going back to my AstroCam, if you want proper back focus, then you need to use spacers that come with the camera. In my case, it's the 21mm and the 16.5mm spacers. And if you want to use a filter drawer or filter wheel, you replace the 21mm spacer for the filter holder since they are the same size. With the DSLR, all you need is the T-ring. I have both M42 and M48 T-rings here. I use the M48 with this flattener because those are the threads that this comes with. So let's start connecting things on the mount and see what it all looks like. So I have my 8060 set up on my CM40 mount here, and in the back I'm going to connect my T2i DSLR. So we'll need to remove the 2-inch barrel here by unscrewing it, and then we can screw in my flattener here. Alright, so the 2-inch backing has been unscrewed, has been removed. And when I turn this, you can see that there are M54 threads inside of this camera angle adjuster. And on this side of the flattener, there are M54 male threads that'll go in and screw on. So on the inside of the M54 male threads, there are actually M48 threads here, so that you can actually screw in 2-inch filters directly onto the flattener here and then screw it on. Generally speaking, you'd want the filter to be closer to the sensor, so having it on this side should be like a last resort if you don't have anything else. But normally you'd want to make sure that it's on this side of the setup. I'm just going to screw this in. Now I have my two T-rings here. Now if my flattener had the M42 threads, I'd use my smaller M42 T-ring and screw it on. But since I have my M48, this is actually the M48, I can just screw this on here. I like doing this before attaching the T-thread or the T-ring to my DSLR, so that my DSLR doesn't go spinning. Screw that on. And now I have my DSLR here, unscrew the cap, and then I can screw this on right here. It should snap on. There you go, satisfying snap. It's upside down, and that's where the camera angle adjuster comes in handy. And if you're using a DSLR, there you go, I can turn it, tighten the knob, and now this is secure. And looking at it again from the side, I have my telescope, I have my flattener that screws directly into the camera rotator, which has the M54 threads, and my T-ring here, and my DSLR. And my T-ring and DSLR back focus, or the spacing between them, gives me the perfect 55 millimeters I need for good back focus. So now I'm gonna take out my DSLR and I'm gonna put in my 523 MC Pro. So I left my flattener here. I'm gonna screw in the two spacers that came with my ZWASIF 523 MC Pro. So first I have the 16.5mm spacer and a 21mm spacer. So that gives me 37.5mm between the two, and the additional, and the 523 MC Pro has another native 17.5mm that makes it all 55mm. So normally I would connect the camera here first and then rotate the whole thing, but just for the purposes here, you know, this is the M42 to M48 ring here, and on the bottom I have the M42 to M42 ring. So I'm just gonna screw this on to the back of the flattener. Pretty easy. And my 523 MC Pro has M42 threads here, so this screws in directly onto the end here. There we go. And now I have the perfect back focus from the end of the flattener here to the sensor on my camera here, once you measure all of these spacers here. And as I said earlier, if you want to put in a filter drawer or a filter wheel, for ZW at least, they're pretty standard. It would replace the 21 millimeter. I think I said 21 and a half millimeter earlier, but it's 21 millimeter spacer here, so it'll go here. And the filter is closer, as close as it could get to the sensor without being directly onto the sensor, which is pretty nice. And this is what the flattener looks like with the AstroCam. If you have any questions about anything I covered, or if I didn't cover anything that you're curious about, let me know in the comments below. And the answer is 42. I hope you'll join me in my next astronomy adventure. Clear skies.